What's up, Tech Squad? Andrew Edwards here, editor-in-chief of GearLive.com. And today I'm bringing you my final verdict on the Google Pixel and Google Pixel XL smartphones. So this is my full review after using these devices for just about 2 full months. After my last video, there were some comments left asking me to report back after I had used it for a longer period of time. So for those of you who requested it, here it is. By the way, big shout out to Upsy for sponsoring this review. I am a big, big fan of Upsy, a company which provides some of the cheapest product warranties for devices like smartphones, tablets, computers, video game consoles, and home appliances. Not only are they cheaper upfront, but they're also cheaper when you need something replaced and have to pay a deductible. I cannot say enough good things about these guys. I protect all my devices with Upsy, and you can too by heading over to Upsy.com. If you want to save even more money off their already cheap warranties, just be sure to put in promo code Andrew10, and that'll save you 10% off the cost of any warranty that you buy. Now, speaking of protection, the Google Pixel and Pixel XL are definitely phones you're gonna want to protect. The hardware is premium with a seamless glass and unibody aluminum construction design. The surfaces are smooth and the curved edges are easy to grip, but can feel slippery. And you also have that odd glass panel on back, which I suspect is there to hide the camera bump. That glass panel is also where the Pixel imprint is. That is the rear fingerprint reader, which can also be used to check out your notifications. Now, the Pixel does not have my favorite physical appearance in the world, especially compared to a lot of the other smartphones out there. It's actually one of my least favorite, but it is very functional. However, if you want to switch it up, you can do something like put a D-brand skin on yours. I put one on mine, as you see here, something that's more in line with my own personal style. So here you see I have the orange skin here on my Pixel, which is my favorite color. I'll leave a link in the description below in case you want to find a D-brand skin for your phone that matches you. Now, that premium hardware on the Pixel is matched up by internal specs that are also top of the line, which is a departure from the Nexus line, which was always seen as being good as far as the software goes, but always more of a mid-range type of phone when you look at the hardware. But now that Google is releasing its own phone from both a hardware and software perspective, things are a little different. To add to a very vivid 24-bit AMOLED display that's 5 inches on the Pixel and 5.5 inches on the Pixel XL, Google has also added a Snapdragon 821 chipset clocked at 2.2 gigahertz under the hood for the whole Pixel lineup. Now, you combine that with the latest version of Android Nougat, which is 7.1 shipping here on the Pixel, and you've got a phone that flies through any task you throw at it on a consistent basis. Now, speaking of Android, the major software differentiator here on the Pixel devices is the Google Assistant. Now, don't get me wrong, it does ship with Android 7.1 Nougat, as I already stated, and you do get all those Android features like the new multitasking and that doze feature, something you'd find on other Android smartphones as well. However, the Google Assistant is unique here, at least when it comes to phones, to the Google Pixel. Google Assistant is the voice assistant found on Pixel smartphones, and it really combines factual and conversational information into a very easy to use interface. It's new, so it's not flawless, but it's definitely a refresh over Google Now, found on all other Android devices, allowing you to get answers, manage daily tasks, find photos easier, and more. The Google Assistant is good today, and it'll only get better with time. Moving on, let's talk about that camera, because Google is very excited about the camera on its Pixel devices. And they're doing some interesting things, not only with the camera itself, but with the photos and videos that that camera takes. The 12.3 megapixel primary camera takes some great pictures in daylight as well as in the night. I'm particularly happy with its HDR Plus mode and fast shutter speed. It also takes some very detailed video at 4K, and stability looks good despite the fact that there's no optical image stabilization. However, when you're taking video, it does use electronic image stabilization, so that's definitely better than nothing. The lens blur feature is really handy, but it doesn't work all the time, especially when the edges of a subject are hard to find. Similar story with the front camera, sporting 8 megapixels and an f2.4 aperture with fixed focus. You get great detail in photos, and it records video in up to 720p resolution. Now, Google has boasted about the DxOMark rating of this smartphone, and that 89 score is the highest score for a smartphone camera in history. However, it's not a stat that I think really makes much of a difference. You got a lot of flagship smartphones these days. All of them have amazing cameras. So what I will say about the Pixel camera is that it fits right in. It can hold its own against the other great smartphone cameras out there and should be seen as one of the best. That said, I would have definitely liked to have seen optical image stabilization included here, or at least included on the Pixel XL. So maybe next year. But staying on that theme of photography, you use your camera to capture memories and moments, and Google has gone above and beyond as far as storing that media because they're providing unlimited photo and video storage at full resolution in Google Photos for all photos taken with a Google Pixel smartphone. So yes, if you own a Pixel, any photos you take, any video you take, including full resolution 4K video, is stored in the cloud completely free at no additional cost. That's a total win for anyone who takes a bunch of photos, selfies, and video because you never have to worry about running out of space. Amazon did this with their Fire Phone, but of course the Fire Phone was a flop. Failed pretty miserably and quickly. So really, it's only Google who's doing this right now. I'd love to see others do this, jump in and provide a similar type of service. Apple, I'm definitely looking at you. And that's really it, guys. After using the phone for a couple of months, that is what sticks out to me the most. It's not so much about the internal specs and things like that. It's really about the everyday usage that I can get out of this phone, and those are the things that stick out to me as being top of the line and worth mentioning. So in my opinion, the Google Pixel is the right phone for the vast majority of Android users. If you put this next to the iPhone 7 or iPhone 7 Plus, you really are comparing two great smartphones and you can't go wrong with either one. And the other thing is these are both mass market devices, and it's more mass market than some of the other Android phones. In fact, I think it's the Android phone with the most mass market appeal. That said, if you need something that's more customized, I'm talking about things like a dual camera or wireless charging or a phone that's waterproof, you're gonna have to look elsewhere, at least for this year. But if you're just looking for a great smartphone experience, the Google Pixel and Pixel XL are definitely worth a look. But now I want to hear from you guys. Did you pick up a new Google Pixel or Google Pixel XL smartphone? If yes, what do you think of it? And if not, what smartphone do you use? Drop a comment below. I'll meet you down there for further discussion. Be sure to click on that like button if you enjoyed this one, and don't forget to click or tap on my face when it shows up somewhere here in the video in order to get subscribed for free, in order to stay on top of all future video releases if you're not subscribed already. And if you're not subscribed already, please do hit that subscribe button. We are almost at 100,000 subscribers, and my goal is to hit that number before the end of the year, which is obviously very, very close at this point. So help a brother out. Until next time, thanks so much for watching, guys. I appreciate your support as always. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I'll catch you in the next video.